Chocolate mania sweeps through Europe. 1606, Italian traveler Antonio Carletti discovers chocolate in Spain and takes it to Italy. From Italy, chocolate spreads to Germany, Austria, Great Britain, France, and Switzerland. During the early 1600s, European empires of Germany, Austria, Great Britain, France, and Switzerland began cultivating and producing chocolate in their own colonies, including Malaysia, West Africa, and Sri Lanka. All, to this day, remain the largest producers of cocoa beans on the planet. During this period of history, cocoa was known as a religious fasting beverage. Because the Catholic Church permitted consumption of cocoa during Lent as a nutritional supplement, it was believed to have medicinal and restorative properties, as well as being an aphrodisiac. In fact, in 1624, chocolate controversy develops. Johann Rausch of Vienna condemns chocolate because it ignites romantic passion and urges monks not to drink it. 1641, cocoa is introduced to Germany by a German scientist named Johann Voldkammer, who discovered it in Naples. The Germans begin the habit of drinking a cup of hot chocolate before bedtime. 1653, chocolate is seen as having medicinal properties. In fact, the first official statement about chocolate is made by Bonaventure d'Aragon, brother of Cardinal Richelieu, describing the use of chocolate as stimulating the healthy functioning of the spleen and other digestive functions. Pharmacists and doctors begin adding their functional and proven medicines to the chocolate recipe. The taste of chocolate made the often bitter and bad taste of many medicines more acceptable. From there, chocolate was regularly prescribed or mixed into medication for all sorts of ailments and diseases. The Dutch doctor, Bontenko, saw chocolate as highly effective against colds and coughing. According to the French Lemery, it promoted digestion, fertility, and human resistance to colds and flu. Chocolate was even considered as brain power to reinforce the mental performance of people. Suffering from depression back in the 1600s? Chocolate was prescribed. The outstanding health benefits of chocolate was confirmed by doctors all over Europe. In 1657, the first chocolate house opens in London, England. Coffee houses were already popular, but now the chocolate house offered this beverage for the elite only. Chocolate houses sprung up all over England. Any person able to pay the extremely high entrance fee was permitted to drink chocolate at these very social establishments. Chocolate was popular amongst the ladies and gents of France during this time too. In 1659, King Louis XIV granted David Chailloux the exclusive right to sell chocolate in Paris, where he continued to do so for the next 30 years. Chocolate was only for the upper crust, to be enjoyed in high society. The word chocolatier is used for the very first time to describe Chailloux's expensive store. In 1672, Sir Hans Sloane brings a cacao tree specimen back from Jamaica to England. During his time in Jamaica, he becomes interested in the bitter drink Jamaicans make by boiling roasted beans from a local tree in water. He believes it to have therapeutic properties, but the taste is disgusting. So he boils the beans in milk and sugar, creating the world's very first milk chocolate drink, what we know today as hot cocoa. He brings his recipe back to England and sells it to an apothecary who markets the product as Sir Hans Sloane's milk chocolate. 1674. In France, eating solid chocolate is introduced in the form of pastilles, a chocolate liquid semi-solidified into a very soft candy that would dissolve in the mouth. In the UK, chocolate is now made into pastries, and chocolate cakes and rolls are served in coffee houses. Meanwhile, in the Caribbean island of Martinique, chocolate is such a part of their culture that it is used as a reference for time. If you were to arrive at chocolate, meant that you were to arrive at 8 p.m. sharp. 1697. Zurich Mayor Heinrich Escher brings chocolate to Switzerland for the very first time from Brussels. Thankfully, because little did he know, 300 years later, Switzerland would be the largest producer of chocolate in the world. You think you like chocolate? Well, you don't like it nearly as much as the Swiss. Switzerland residents hold the record of eating, on average, 26 pounds of chocolate per person per year, while the average American eats only 12 pounds. The 1700s helped the evolution of chocolate processing with the invention of the steam engine, which made it possible for the machine grinding of cocoa beans. This allowed large quantities of beans to be processed with very little labor, causing a decrease in price. Within 30 years, the price of cocoa dropped so significantly it was available to nearly everyone.